गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11. सो मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स सम पार्ट्स हैव बीन डिटेक्टेड. दैट्स व्हाई ओनली फ्यू पार्ट्स आर देयर एंड फ्रॉम देयर वन टॉपिक इज इनफ्लोरेशंस एंड अनदर वन इज डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ ए फ्लावर. सो टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इनफ्लोरेशंस एंड डिफरेंट पार्ट्स और डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लावर्स. ओके, सो फर्स्ट इज इनफ्लोरेशंस. So what is inflorescence? Inflorescence is the arrangement of flower on the floral axis. There is a floral axis and on the floral axis different flowers are arranged in different ways. So these are called as inflorescence. And next, what are the different types of inflorescence? Mainly three types of inflorescence can be found. One is racemose type of inflorescence, another one is cymose type of inflorescence, and next one is mixed type of inflorescence. So I am repeating, what is inflorescence? That is arrangement of flower. So what is flower? Flower is a modified shoot. Shoot is modified into flower. So this flower is arranged in the floral axis in different ways, and this type of arrangement is called as inflorescence. So next is type of inflorescence. What are the different types of inflorescence? First one is racemose, second one cymose, and last one is mixed type of inflorescence. So under the racemose type of inflorescence, it looks like that. Like that, okay. That means the main axis of the flower continue to grow and the flowers are born in acropetal order. The main axis will continue to grow and the flowers will be in acropetal order. That means the youngest flower will be at the top. The flower which is in the top position, that is the youngest flower, and the base, the flower which is present at the base, that is the oldest flower. Okay, so this type of arrangement is called as acropetal arrangement or acropetal order. I am repeating, the youngest flower will be at the top and the oldest flower will be at the base, and this type of arrangement is called as acropetal order. And another one is the main axis will continue to grow. Okay, and this is called as racemose type of inflorescence, and it is found in mustard. In mustard we will find racemose type of inflorescence. Next one is cymose type of inflorescence. This type of arrangement is called as cymose type of inflorescence. So in that case the main axis will terminate and they will not grow further. That means the main axis gets terminated to a flower, hence the growth is limited. Hence the growth is limited, and this type of, and flowers are born in basipetal arrangement or basipetal order. What is basipetal order? That means central flower is oldest. This flower is oldest, and the flowers which are present at the base, they are new. Or they are youngest. Okay, this type of arrangement is called as basipetal arrangement. And under these racemose and so now we can differentiate between cymose and racemose type of inflorescence, and it is found in jasmine. It is found in jasmine and mixed type of inflorescence means which. These two types can be found, and it can be found in ficus, and there are so many other examples also in which this type of inflorescence can be found. And under these racemose and cymose type of and mixed type of inflorescence, they are divided into many other types. Like under the racemose type of inflorescence, it is raceme, panicle, spike, corym, umbel, capitula. These are the different types. And under cymose type of inflorescence, we will be able to find different type and after mixed type hypanthodium, cyathium. Okay, these are the some types, but in your book only these main two types are there. That's why you have to read this part only. Okay, so now you can differentiate between the racemose and cymose type of inflorescence. So what are the main differences between the racemose and cymose? That means in racemose type of inflorescence, the terminal bud continue to grow and the main axis has intermediate growth. And in case of cymose type of inflorescence, the terminal bud becomes a flower and main axis has determined growth. The main axis has determined growth. And the flower next difference is in case of racemose, that is flowers are born in acropetal order, and in case of cymose, flowers are born in basipetal order. Acropetal order means older flowers are at the base and younger flowers are towards the apex. Older flowers are at the base and younger flower at the apex. And acropetal order means that older flowers are at the top and younger flowers are at the base. Okay, and so these are the and another one difference is there in between racemose and cymose is the flower opening is centripetal. In case of racemose, the flower opening is centripetal. So what is centripetal? That means outer or basal flowers, outer or basal flowers will open first and the central flowers or the upper flowers will open later. So the opening of the flowers in case of racemose is centripetal. That means the outer flowers or basal flowers will open first and the central flower will open later. And in case of cymose, the opening is centrifugal. So flower opening is centrifugal. That means the central flower open first and the outer or basal flower will open later. Central flower will open first and the basal flower will open later. Okay, why? Because the oldest flower is in the middle position. So oldest flower will open first, as in that case the oldest flower is at the base. That's why the outer basal flowers are opening first. Okay, so these are the main differences or main criteria of racemose and cymose type of inflorescence. Next we will see the different parts or the flower. So next part is flower. So what is flower? Flower is the reproductive part of angiosperm. Okay, that is modified shoot. First I have mentioned that flower is the modified shoot and it is the reproductive part also. It is the reproductive part of a plant. Okay, flower is the reproductive part of mainly angiospermic plants, flower plants. That means because angiosperms are flowering plants. Okay. So now we will see the different parts of a flower or general criteria of a flower. So in case of flowers, four holes are present. What are they? These are calyx, corolla, androecium, and gynoecium. Androecium and gynoecium. Okay, so these are the main parts of a flower. Or flowers are having floral holes. These are calyx. I am repeating: calyx, corolla, androecium, and gynoecium. G-Y-N-O-E is there. Okay, so these are the main four holes of a flower. Now, before knowing about the four holes of a flower, first we will know some criteria or some types of flower. Flowers may be bisexual or unisexual. Flowers may be bisexual, unisexual. Flowers may be complete or incomplete. So what does that mean, complete flower and incomplete flower? If all the floral whorls are present in a flower, in a single flower, this type of flower is called as complete flower. But if all the floral whorls are not present in a single flower, is called as incomplete flower. If any one floral whorl is absent in any flower, this type of flower is called as incomplete flower. And if all floral whorls are present, it is called as complete flower. Next one is bisexual flower and unisexual flower. Bisexual flower means, as I have mentioned, that these four parts, calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. Androecium is considered as male reproductive system or male reproductive part, and gynoecium is female reproductive part. Okay, so if in flower both male and female reproductive part, that means androecium and gynoecium is present, this type of flower is called as bisexual. That means both male and female reproductive sexual parts are present, that's why it is called as bisexual flower. But if in flower the only one part is present, that means either androecium or gynoecium is present, that type of flower is called as unisexual flower. So I am repeating, if in flower both androecium and gynoecium, that means male and female reproductive system is present, that type of flower is called as bisexual flower. But if any flower only one type of or either male or female type of reproductive system is present, that type of flower is called as unisexual flower. Bisexual flowers are easily seen in hibiscus or China rose, and unisexual flowers can be found in date, palm, papaya. Okay, so these are the examples of bisexual and unisexual flower. So next we will see the different parts of a flower. So what are they? These are the different parts of a flower. You have to know, first one is pedicel. Okay, first one is, I am talking about pedicel. Pedicel is the stalk of the flower. Flowers are having, in some flowers are having a stalk like structure. This stalk like structure is called as pedicel. Next part is thalamus, and alternative name of thalamus is receptacles. While flower whorls are successfully arranged, that means when floral whorls are arranged, this structure, this solen structure or solen base of the flower is called as thalamus. Okay, the solen end of the pedicel on which the floral parts are arranged, this part is called as thalamus or receptacle. Okay, and next one is bract. A flower normally arises in the axis of the small leaf-like structure. This is called bract. A flower normally arises in the axil of the small leaf-like structure. This structure is called bract. In some flowers, this bract may be present, or in some flowers, it may not. So, if the bract is present, it is called as bractate. If the bract is present, this type of flower is called as bractate flower. And if that bract structure is absent, that type of flower is called as e-bractate flower. Okay? So, these are the some important parts of a flower. Next, we will see the symmetry in flowers. According to the symmetry, flowers can be differentiated into three: actinomorphic, zygomorphic, and amorphic. So, what is actinomorphic? Flowers which are having radial symmetry. Are known as actinomorphic. What is zygomorphic? Flowers which are having bilateral symmetry. And flowers which are having no symmetry are called as amorphic. Okay, I am repeating, the symmetry in case of flowers can be differentiated into three. Flowers they are actinomorphic, zygomorphic, and amorphic. So when the flowers can be divided into two equal halves in any radial planes passing through the center, it is called as actinomorphic. That means they are having mainly radial type of symmetry, and these type of arrangements can be found in Datura, mustard. Okay, so if we cut the flower, if this is the floral axis, if we cut the flower in any axis, we will get through the center, we will get two similar parts. This type of arrangement is called as actinomorphic symmetry. Next one is bilateral symmetry. Sorry, next one is zygomorphic. When it can be divided into two similar halves, if we cut the flower in one particular vertical plane. Okay, that type of flower is called as, if we cut the flower in any particular plane, and only that time we will get, that means only if we cut the flower in only one plane, then we will get two similar parts. This type of symmetry is called as zygomorphic, or it is called as bilateral symmetry. It can be found in pea, gulma, horn, bean. Okay. And last one is, if we cut the flower in any plane, we will not get any type of symmetry. This type of arrangement is called as amorphic. It can be found in Kana. So these are the different types of flowers according to the symmetry. Next, flowers can be differentiated into some parts according to the arrangement of floral appendages. So what are they? They may be pentameras, trimeras, tetrameras. Okay, so a flower may be about the pedicel. In some plants, pedicel is also absent. So in which the pedicel is present, they are called pedicellate flowers, and those in which the pedicel is absent, it is called as sessile flower. Okay, so next part is another type of flower, that is trimeras, tetrameras, pentameras. On which this type of divisions can be there? That a flower may be trimeras, tetrameras, pentameras when the floral appendages are present in the multiple of 3, multiple of 4, or multiple of 5 respectively. If the floral appendages are present in multiple of 3, that means 3 or 6 or 9, okay, like that, these type of flowers will be called as trimeras flower. If the floral appendages are present in multiple of 4, then 4, 8, 16, that type of flower will be called as tetrameras. If the appendages are present in multiple of 5, then 5, 10, 15, like that, these type of arrangements are called as pentameras flower. Okay. So these are the, according to the flow number of floral appendages, these are the another types of flowers. Okay. And next division is that, according to the position of the ovary, we can differentiate flower into three, that is hypogynous flower, perigynous flower, and epigynous flower. Okay. So now, in respect to the gynoecium, we will differentiate flower into three. Respect to gynoecium, we can differentiate flower into three. These are hypogynous, perigynous, and epigynous. Okay, now we will see that these three different types of flower in respect to the position of the gynoecium. Okay, so first I will discuss about the hypogynous flower. So if the ovary is in superior position, so in that the ovary is superior. If the ovary is in superior position, that type of flower is called as hypogynous flower. And if the ovary is half inferior, that type of flower is called as perigynous flower. And if the ovary is below, that means if the ovary is inferior, that type of flower is called as epigynous flower. Okay, so I will tell the different properties. That means when the ovary is situated, in case I am discussing about the hypogynous flower, that means when the ovary is situated at the base, that means in case of hypogynous flower, the gynoecium occupies the highest position. When the gynoecium, that means ovary, occupies the highest position and the other parts will be situated below the ovary. Ovary will be on the top position and like that. If it is ovary, the other floral parts, that means androecium, petals, sepals will be below the ovary. Ovary will be on the top position. That type of ovary is called as superior ovary, and that type of flower is called as hypogynous flower. That means ovary will be at the top position and the other floral parts will be below the ovary. This type of flower is called as hypogynous flower. Okay, so this type of flower, example of this type of flower is called as mustard, tomato, etc. Next is perigynous flower. That means in case of perigynous flower, when the these flowers are located at the rim of the thalamus, almost the level, that means almost the center level. Okay, that means it is present in half a position. Okay, this type of flower is called as perigynous flower, and this type of ovary is called as, in your book, just follow that part, it will help you to understand that part. Okay, and last one is epigynous flower. So in that case, in case of perigynous flower, ovary is in central position. Okay, ovary is in central position, and example is palm, rose, etc. And last one is epigynous flower. That means ovary is inferior, that means ovary is below. Other parts of the flowers are present above the ovary, just opposite to the hypogynous flower. In case of epigynous flower, the ovary completely, that means ovary is inferior, ovary is in the below, and the other floral parts are above the ovary. This type of arrangement is called as epigynous flower, and the ovary is position of the is considered as inferior position, that means in below that part. Okay, examples of this part are guava, cucumber, etc. So these are the main three types, and just I am repeating once again, whenever you are reading that part, follow the diagrams in your book. Okay, so it will help you to understand this part. So according to the position of the gynoecium, flowers can be differentiated into these three. So these are the general criteria or general parts or general divisions of a flower. In my next class, I will discuss about the main characteristics of these four whorls. That means calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. For today, that's it, and thank you.